Praise God. There's another one. There's another one.
Those who live dissolutely, indifferent to moral restraints, indulging in sensual pleasures or vices, uninhibited perversion and debauchery, shall be abandoned, forsaken, and deserted, because they are shameless and wicked, wherein they think it strange that ye run not with them to the same excess of riot, speaking evil of you. Whoso keepeth the law is a wise son, but he that is a companion of riotous men shameth his father. The angels of Yahweh declare, you shall be saved, kept safe and sound, rescued from danger or destruction, from injury or peril. You shall be saved from suffering, from disease, to be made well, healed, and restored to health. Yah shall preserve those in danger of destruction. You shall be saved and rescued, delivered from the penalties of the messianic judgment, and saved from evils, saved from the peril of this hour. You shall be partaker of the salvation of Christ, being delivered from error and corrupt notions, to be in a state of moral purity, in pardon of sin, and in the blessed peace of a soul reconciled to God. At the visible return of Christ from heaven, you shall be perfected in the consummate blessings of Yah, saved and transported into heaven. The Lord shall deliver me from every evil work and will preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. The Alpha and Omega shall appear and bring light, to become visible as a star, to become clearly known, to show himself, to bring us forth into light, and cause us to shine bright and resplendent, as the appearance of the angels exposed to view. We shall see God and those restored to life shine as the heavenly light that surrounds the angels when they appear on earth as a star of fire, as a lamp or torch, or heavenly luminary. Christ's brightness symbolizes his rank, influence, worth, and mighty deeds, the divine Shekinah, the subtle, pure light, which is incorporeal, spotless, and holy, which represents a state of supreme sanctity, of consummate majesty, inaccessible to human comprehension, that heavenly state, free from every imperfection, to which the true disciples of Christ will be exalted, the kingdom of light. You shall be imbued with saving wisdom. Your wisdom and spiritual purity shall shine forth, and you shall take on the nature of light, so that its true character and quality are no longer hidden, but exposed to the view of all. The angels of Yahweh declare, make known your thoughts, declare them, spread and disseminate an account of this event, describing in detail what you have observed. Shed light that it become clear and manifest. Yahweh's heavenly light shall be seen upon the bodies of men, and the disorderly, unruly, undisciplined, who are wild and lacking restraint, shall be put in order. The Alpha and Omega is without offspring. He is childless, but we shall become his children. Children of God, by the bonds of love, friendship, and trust. He shall render to us his help and assistance, and he shall execute vengeance, punishment, and penalty on those who are profligate and licentious. He shall be our guardian, coming to help us and to take vengeance on them. He paid the price for us in blood money when he shed his blood on the cross, washing away our sins. And for that reason, we have a mark of honor, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel in sanctification and honor. Those who have no honor shall suffer punishment. The Alpha and Omega shall manifest to be conspicuous and remarkable, illustrious and glorious, shining brightly, that he may be known throughout the world. When he appears, clear as the light of fire, we shall be outside of the compass, limits, range, and scope of the tumult, commotion, disturbance, and violent agitation that shall come. They shall be in turmoil, a state of extreme confusion and uproar, because they are excluded from God's will and intervention. They shall be omitted from his authority and desire regarding his property when he intercedes for us, because they are separated from Christ, alienated from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers to the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. The angels of Yahweh declare, he shall take and carry you away with a gust of wind, and you shall be moved inwardly. He shall bear you up to keep you from falling. Christ, the preserver of the universe, shall abstain from punishing or destroying you. Announce and bring this forward in a speech, resting upon this declaration, upon the ground of truth. An obligation has been laid upon you, and you shall be in the presence of God at the end of the days, supported by hope, relying upon the name of Messiah, and you shall do anything upon the name of Christ. The two witnesses shall testify to the matter at hand. At the mouth of two witnesses shall every word be established. Your purpose and end is to worship and profess his name. That which thou hast come for, do, fulfill, perform, execute, and carry out your purpose. He shall blow upon you, and you shall be moved toward that place. This is your actual and intended arrival. Call upon the name of Jesus, that help may come from that name. The two shall be brought together and assembled in the same place, and you shall be brought near to judges and kings to their tribunals, and Christ shall be your right hand against the adversary. Blessings shall come upon you from heaven, and you shall be in a trance. The Holy Spirit shall rest upon you to put a covenant upon you. This is your purpose and end. On the morrow, he shall rest his influence upon you to oversee and direct you, that you may cry out, shout, and cry against them. The cock shall crow, men shall cry out, and he shall call you to send for and summon you, to call you out to come to him. He shall invite and call you by name. His voice as a musical instrument shall be noised abroad. It shall shine and be clear. Men shall wail and lament at the sound of his uttered words. Declarations from heaven shall be heard. The one who uttered the voice is Jesus. The shepherd's cry, the sound of the words of Christ, shall recall the dead to life. This is the resurrection cry, the awakening shout of the archangel, the leader of the angelic hosts, teaching, admonishing, and shaking the earth. This speech, this preaching, prophecy, language, and tongue is meant to shed light, that these events may become evident, clear, and manifest. The appearance of the angels exposed to view as the light of fire is the light of truth, and its knowledge together with spiritual purity exposed to the view of all openly and publicly, that you may have the power of understanding moral and spiritual truth. This preaching consists of light, and the light is the illumining power, the divine Shekinah, as an appellation of God, signifying its nobility and majesty. It is the saving truth embodied in Christ, and by his love and effort, it is imparted to mankind. The angels of Yahweh declare, make known your thoughts, that the heavenly light may shine upon men. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. Amen. Shalom. Thank you.